a strategic position at the crossroads of Europe, Africa, the Arab world and the Maghreb region, Morocco is reshaping itself as a regional leader and business gateway to Africa. Its commitment to making growth more inclusive is now recognized across the continent. As King Mohammed VI of Morocco recently stated, Africa should learn to trust Africa. Our continent does not need assistance so much as mutually profitable partnerships. Africa needs human and social development projects much more than it needs humanitarian aid.
Les investisseurs sont très bien là où il faut aller. Ils veulent aller dans les pays stables. Ils veulent aller dans les pays où il y a la sécurité. Et ils veulent aller dans les pays où il y a la justice.
Le Maroc, depuis sur les 10 dernières années, a enregistré une croissance moyenne de l'ordre de 4,2-4,3% par an, qui le place sur parmi les pays de sa zone le plus performant en matière donc de taux de croissance.
The government has put in place development strategies for each of Morocco's key sectors, including industry, energy, transport and infrastructure, health and education. Growth is expected to consolidate at a healthy 5% for the years ahead.
Nous avons évolué sur le dawang business de 97, de la place 97 à la place 71. C'est une amélioration formidable parce que nous avons fourni de grands efforts pour améliorer le climat des affaires et permettre aux gens de travailler plus facilement, que ce soit des investisseurs étrangers ou des investisseurs nationaux.
Morocco's success and economic growth is credited to shrewd business planning, but also on the insistence of making growth work for all parts of society.
Le Maroc travaille pour augmenter son potentiel, mais également pour que cette croissance soit inclusive et que cette croissance puisse permettre donc à l'ensemble des populations de tirer profit du développement donc de leur pays.
Since ascending to the throne in 1999, King Mohammed VI has sanctioned wide-ranging economic and political reforms aimed at fighting poverty and inequality while promoting economic development. Much the same way, Morocco's government now follows an agenda of reforms that will change almost every part of civic life in Morocco, including the effectiveness of public spending, the judiciary, and freedom of expression. Achieving greater cohesion between regions is part of this agenda. This is particularly important for Morocco's south. Between 2004 and 2010, a total of $1 billion has been invested in economic and social projects, raising the region's indicators for education, health and poverty reduction above the national average.
40 years ago was about 25%, the percentage of the poverty. Now it's, for example, in Laayoune, 2.2%. In Dakhla, 2.6%.
A new development model, backed by the king, aims to double the region's GDP over the next 10 years and create 120,000 new jobs.
For us, the South is the gateway to sub-Saharan African countries. A vision that has been developed by His Majesty the King Mohammed VI in order to promote prosperity, social justice in Africa.
Increasingly, Morocco is seen as a development partner for Africa's fast-growing economies.
We are trying to help as much as we can by maybe transferring our know-how in different sectors such as finance, agriculture, telecommunication, electrification, social housing, education and others.
Moroccan companies are already present in more than 25 African countries through major investments, subsidiaries and businesses in a variety of sectors. This gives Morocco an entrepreneurial advantage and makes it the natural gateway for international investors.
Nous sommes un pays qui donne la possibilité à des entreprises internationales de pouvoir découvrir l'Afrique, de pouvoir investir en Afrique, tout en bénéficiant de l'infrastructure légale, l'infrastructure physique du Maroc.
Morocco's expanding international engagement is reflected by a rise in foreign direct investment. In recent years, Morocco has attracted an average of $3 billion annually. In the first half of 2015, foreign investments in Morocco rose to $1.32 billion. Compared to $1.1 billion during the same period last year, representing a 19.6% increase. Investments are made across sectors, from industry, tourism, energy and infrastructure, to financial services, technology and telecommunications.
Nous savons exactement ce que nous voulons dans chaque secteur d'activité. Et le meilleur exemple, c'est dans le secteur de l'industrie, où les écosystèmes ont été développés. Et nous savons dans chaque écosystème qu'est-ce que nous devons aller chercher comme investisseurs étrangers.
Morocco's recent focus on value-added export industries makes the country a magnet for foreign investors. Thanks to a strategy that has strengthened six designated sectors, the kingdom is developing into a modern, industrialized nation. This strategy, based on the National Pact for Industrial Emergence, launched in 2008, has boosted the aeronautics, agro-industry, automotive, offshoring, pharmaceuticals and textile sectors, thereby increasing exports and modernizing local industries.
Nous commençons à recevoir des flux dans le secteur industriel qui allaient en Asie et qui se trouvent revenir au Maroc.
A new industrial acceleration plan was launched last year to run from 2014 to 2020. It is planned to lead to the creation of 500,000 jobs and to increase industry's contribution to GDP from 14% to 23%.
Nous avons, en moins d'une année, depuis le plan d'accélération industrielle, il a été lancé en avril 2014, lancé la création de 238 000 nouveaux emplois au Maroc dans le secteur industriel.
The new strategy is based on an approach of integrated value chains and the creation of synergies between big firms and SMEs.
Aujourd'hui, nous venons de réorganiser le secteur industriel sous forme d'écosystèmes. Et ces écosystèmes-là créent énormément de synergies et de croissance.
Canadian aerospace company Bombardier, a leading manufacturer of both business and commercial aircrafts, is an example of successful integration into the local business ecosystem.
Derrière Bombardier qui s'est installé au Maroc, nous avons 137 entreprises d'équipementiers qui fournissent Bombardier, mais qui fournissent aussi l'ensemble des constructeurs d'avions dans le monde.
Construction of Bombardier's permanent facility, completed in Casablanca in September 2013, is a major endorsement of Morocco's growing aerospace industry.
Our plan here is to invest up to $200 million by 2020, and in doing so, create 850 jobs in aerospace. We're committed to work very closely with the local government, and in doing so, also be a catalyst for the development of the local supply chain here in Morocco.
The creation of new ecosystems also applies to other industries, including the automotive sector, which has attracted investments from companies such as Renault, Peugeot and Ford. In 2012, Renault opened a state-of-the-art production plant in Tangier.
Cette usine, ces produits sont idéalement placés à la fois pour alimenter le marché européen et pour répondre aux besoins du marché africain qui va se développer dans les années à venir.
PSA Peugeot Citroën has also revealed plans to build a $630 million Moroccan factory to begin assembling small and subcompact models by 2019.
Nous sommes aujourd'hui dans le secteur automobile à 600 000 véhicules de capacité de fabrication au Maroc, qui fait du Maroc un player mondial de taille raisonnable, mais avec une projection dans les 5 prochaines années d'arriver à 1 million de véhicules fabriqués au Maroc. Donc nous serons un acteur incontournable dans ce domaine-là.
Morocco's well-connected infrastructure facilitates these developments. Modern infrastructure, such as the Tangier Med port, highways, rail and air links, and logistics zones, are now turning the country into a major transport hub for travelers and trade.
Nous avons investi énormément d'argent pour que notre pays soit doté des systèmes et des infrastructures de transport qui permettent donc une mobilité aisée, donc une mobilité tant au niveau national qu'au niveau international.
Situated on the world's second busiest shipping lane, linking Asia to Europe and North America, Morocco's port traffic is expected to triple by 2030. The Tangier Med port, a modern cargo port, completed less than a decade ago, anticipates this growth.
Les plus grands opérateurs de terminaux à conteneurs qui sont installés dans ce port et qui contribuent à une très grande connectivité du port qui est relié à 160 ports dans le monde et 60 pays.
A second deep water port, Tangier Med 2, is already in preparation and will be fully operational in 2017. This will make Tangier Med port one of the largest ports in Africa, with a total capacity of 8.2 million TEU. Morocco is also planning longer and better roads and highways to link the country's interior with the coast and to drive development in the kingdom's southern regions.
En 2015, fin 2015, début 2016, nous allons avoir à peu près 1800 km. C'est pas suffisant. Nous considérons que nous pouvons développer d'ici 2035 2000 km en plus, donc qui permettront de connecter le centre du Maroc, qui permettront de connecter le sud du Maroc.
Morocco's national railway operator, ONCF, plays an equal part in developing the country, intending to lay 1500 kilometers of high-speed lines in the next three decades.
Nous voulons développer le train, d'abord terminer ce qu'on a déjà lancé pour le train rapide, surtout entre Casablanca et Tanger, mais nous voulons bien sûr étendre le réseau pour le train rapide et le train, ce qu'on appelle nous le LGV, au sud du Maroc, jusqu'à Marrakech, peut-être même jusqu'à Agadir, et même connecter Rabat avec Fès.
The new line will be the fastest in Africa, reducing the travel time between Casablanca and Tangier from nearly 6 hours to just over 2 hours. The anticipated cost of $2 billion will be financed through a combination of public funds and foreign loans. Casablanca's Mohammed V International Airport is also being expanded to meet the standards of a growing international and regional transport hub. While Marrakech, Morocco's premier tourist attraction, will receive a second airport to help deal with the increase in passengers, which is expected to exceed 40 million in 2030. Significantly, these developments not only aid Morocco's integration in the global economy, but also facilitate the expansion of local industries. Morocco's soil is rich in minerals, most famously phosphate rock, sometimes referred to as Morocco's white gold. Morocco holds about 85% of the world's remaining phosphate reserves, which are used around the world in agriculture and industry.
Dans quelques années, nous fêterons un siècle de l'expérience marocaine dans le domaine des phosphates. Alors, c'est dire que nous avons capitalisé sur cette expérience pour justement monter dans la chaîne de valeur de la production des phosphates.
OCP, a state-owned company, has exploited and marketed the country's phosphate reserves since 1920, turning into the world's leading exporter of phosphate. Now, a major capital investment and industrial development program is set to further strengthen its position.
Donc c'est tout un programme qui a nécessité pratiquement 20 milliards de dollars d'investissement qui permettrait justement au Maroc, à terme, d'arriver à avoir 40% du marché mondial dans les phosphates bruts, 40% du marché mondial dans l'acide phosphorique et 40% du marché mondial dans les engrais.
With the global need for agricultural products to double between 2000 and 2050, the production of fertilizers becomes ever more important. Some of the biggest growth markets for OCP are today found in Africa.
Il y a quelques années, on exportait sur le continent africain 50 000 tonnes d'engrais. Maintenant, on est passé à 400 000 tonnes. Et notre objectif, c'est d'arriver à exporter 2 millions de tonnes d'engrais.
Aside from phosphate, the government is planning to expand mining for minerals, such as silver, gold, iron, zinc, lead, copper, cobalt and barite.
J'espère que dans les années à venir, dans quelques années, nous allons multiplier ce chiffre d'affaires par 3 et doubler le nombre d'emplois que nous avons. C'est un secteur qui emploie pratiquement 15 000. Dans les prochaines années, il va faire certainement 30 000.
Similarly ambitious plans exist for the country's booming agriculture and fishery sectors. Agriculture and agro-industry play a significant role in Morocco's economy. Combined, they contribute a total of 19% to the gross domestic product and in rural areas account for more than 70% of all jobs. Morocco's agricultural sector is the largest in the region, with top exports including fresh and processed fruits and vegetables, olive oil, spices and nuts. To boost the sector, the government has launched a strategic development plan known as the Green Morocco Plan. By 2020, agriculture is expected to contribute $18 billion to GDP, create an additional 1.15 million jobs, and triple the income of nearly 3 million people in rural areas. The potential for higher value goods is highlighted by the success of argan oil. Traditionally made for domestic use, argan oil is today recognized globally as a gourmet food item and ingredient in high-end personal care products.
entre 1999 jusqu'à 2004, il n'y avait pas vraiment une grande... je peux dire c'est les années les plus difficiles parce que c'est les débuts, c'est normal.
Germany first developed a taste for the product after funding the first Moroccan women's cooperatives promoting the oil internationally.
2005, on a commencé à exporter jusqu'à 10 tonnes en Allemagne, surtout pour le cosmétique.
Large multinational companies now dominate the sector and have raised exports to more than 2,500 tons annually. By 2020, the government wants to triple this output. Morocco is also the largest producer and exporter of fish in Africa. The Alioune Tis plan, a development plan for the fisheries sector, expects to increase fish landings to 1.6 million tons annually. By modernizing the fishing industry and improving competitiveness and performance, Morocco plans to raise the value of seafood exports to more than $3.1 billion by 2020. Until recently, 90% of Morocco's energy needs were covered through energy imports. This is changing as the country develops local energy sources, particularly renewable energy sources, where it has an enormous potential.
Nous allons développer dans les années à venir trois grands programmes. Un programme de 2000 MW pour le solaire et un programme de 2000 MW au moins pour l'éolien et un programme de 2000 MW pour l'hydroélectricité, ce qui nous ferait en 2020 une production électrique de 42% de sources renouvelables, qui est un chiffre inédit sur le plan régional et je dirais même sur le plan international.
The Nour Solar Power Complex in Ouaz Azat in southern central Morocco, with a projected total capacity of 500 megawatts of electricity, is the first building block in the National Solar Energy Program.
La première centrale aujourd'hui, qui est Nour 1, d'une capacité de 160 MW, sera mise en exploitation cette année, en 2015. Ensuite, les deuxièmes centrales qui utilisent une technologie qui permet de produire de l'électricité même quand le soleil n'est plus là, qui s'appelle donc Nord 2 et Nord 3 sur le complexe de Ouaz Azat, vont démarrer les constructions très bientôt pour une mise en exploitation à partir de 2017. D'ici la fin d'année, nous allons lancer la préqualification sur un autre site qui s'appelle le site de Nord Midelt, où là aussi nous allons développer des centrales avec un mix technologique, thermosolaire et photovoltaïque, qui serait à même, comme on l'a fait jusque-là, d'apporter la réponse la plus utile aux besoins du pays.
An equally impressive development is the Tarfaya wind farm in southwestern Morocco. Operational since December 2014, it is the biggest wind farm in Africa, with 131 turbines and a combined installed capacity of more than 300 megawatts.
It is estimated that Tarfaya wind farm will help reduce Morocco's CO2 emissions by 900,000 tons per year. It will also allow to save more than $190 million of imported oil.
Morocco also emphasizes the massive introduction of natural gas as part of its energy strategy. Over the next 5 years, it will install infrastructure to make liquefied natural gas more available.
Donc c'est un grand projet puisqu'il y aura bien sûr un port avec un quai méthanier, un pipeline qui va faire 400 km avec des centrales à cycle combiné aux alentours de 3000 MW. Donc ce qui explique que c'est un projet qui va coûter 4,5 milliards de dollars, qui va être totalement financé par le secteur privé.
While Morocco is taking measures to meet growing demand for both primary energy and electricity, this very demand is also the outcome of a successful program of nationwide electrification.
99% de la population marocaine qui est, j'allais dire, raccordée au réseau électrique. Et ça, c'est un chiffre très important parce que si vous revenez aux années 90, on était pratiquement à 18%. Donc nous avons fait un effort très important qui nous a coûté pratiquement 2,5 milliards d'euros d'investissement.
Demand for electricity grows by 7 to 8% annually, driven by Morocco's expanding business sector. Morocco's information and communication technologies sector is moving toward deeper integration with the global knowledge economy. The strategic plan, Digital Morocco 2013, makes information technology a cornerstone of the economy.
Dans ce cadre, il s'agit d'une stratégie qui va au-delà des technologies de l'information, les technologies étant un outil, mais pour permettre la transformation numérique de la société, que ce soit sur le plan économique ou sur le plan sociétal d'une manière plus générale, et de permettre au Maroc de profiter de tendances lourdes et d'asseoir une économie numérique.
Morocco is already leading the way in outsourcing and offshoring. Its best-known offshoring project, the Casa Nearshore Park in Casablanca, is the result of a $341 million investment by MedSourcing, a government partner that also operates technology parks in Fez, Oujar and Rabat. The development is home to 100 businesses, including blue-chip companies such as Dell and Accenture. In 2013, IBM here created a service center to serve Moroccan and other African markets.
Le Maroc a une volonté. Il a un devoir, de par sa situation géostratégique, et de jouer ce rôle pour pouvoir créer un hub d'intégration entre l'Europe et l'Afrique.
In a separate initiative, a Moroccan digital fund has been set up to give technical and financial assistance to local technology firms, managed by the country's three biggest commercial banks and the state-owned deposit and management fund. The initiative underlines the role of the financial sector in the country's development. The Moroccan economy proved resilient in the global financial crisis of 2008, thanks to a carefully regulated banking sector. By aligning its institutional, legislative, and regulatory framework with international best practices, Morocco's financial sector has reached a level of development that now puts it at the forefront in the region.
La santé aujourd'hui de notre banque marocaine est une santé reconnue au niveau à l'échelle internationale. Le ratio de solvabilité de nos banques est au-delà donc de ratio de la moyenne donc exigée par Bâle 3. Et nos banques marocaines aujourd'hui commencent à avoir une présence très significative dans un certain nombre de pays d'Afrique subsaharienne.
On a enregistré un taux exceptionnel de bancarisation au cours des 3-4 dernières années seulement, où le niveau de bancarisation a atteint actuellement plus de 65% de la population du pays. Alors que la moyenne au niveau du continent africain, hors Afrique du Sud, ne dépasse même pas 10%. C'est dire que même avec 65, tous les systèmes bancaires font des efforts pour bancariser le pays.
Morocco's three major banks, Attijari Wafa Bank, BMCE Bank, and the Banque Populaire, play a crucial role in the country's economic growth and projecting this growth across Africa.
Aujourd'hui, nous avons trois banques marocaines qui sont présentes dans le continent africain et qui exportent leur savoir-faire et leur savoir en termes bancaires.
While developed countries are experiencing an economic slowdown, Africa stands out as a major source of global growth. Casablanca Finance City is a financial center that was established to act as a conduit for foreign investment.
Le projet Casablanca Finance City qui vise à ériger Casablanca comme une place financière régionale.
Our ecosystem today is fully operational. We have roughly 80 international companies that have set up in Casablanca under the CFC status, addressing their African markets from Casablanca.
Companies setting up in the finance city value Morocco's vantage point.
If you want to set up a financial hub, you need some prerequisites, which are stability, regulation, infrastructure, and at least connectivity. And Morocco offers all these prerequisites.
Other sectors look for similar criteria. International tourism, for example, has long favored Morocco over neighboring countries, not least because of the stability and unique infrastructure it offers. Morocco has become a benchmark for tourism development throughout the Mediterranean region. And the Vision 2020 strategy, announced in 2010, aims to extend this success.
Well, the Vision 2020 is a national program, it's a national ambition for Morocco. The main objective of the Vision is to make Morocco among the top destinations, 20 destinations around the world, but also to make it a reference destination when it comes to sustainable development. And actually, the target is to double the sector of tourism of Morocco.
Ecotourism is one of the more prominent segments in this regard. but the meetings, incentives, conferences and events sector has also grown in recent years, as has medical tourism. Sports tourism is also expected to increase, particularly golf, and several ports are planned or undergoing expansion in order to attract more cruise ships. Marrakech, Morocco's cultural jewel, with its magical souks, gardens, palaces, and first-class facilities, was named the world's number one tourist destination in 2015 by travel website TripAdvisor. Morocco's tremendous tourism potential is reflected by the presence of luxury hotel brands such as Sofitel, Four Seasons, Grace, and Ritz-Carlton. The Moroccan government also invests in emerging destinations like Fez and Meknès, and in the south of Morocco, in the Dakhla region, in the Moroccan Sahara. Dakhla has become a center for fans of windsurfing and kitesurfing, as well as nature lovers visiting the Gulf of Sintra and the Bank Dagin, a UNESCO World Heritage Site. In 2013, the Al Shafi Investment Group launched a $99 million ecotourism desert resort in Dakhla.
We succeeded in developing an international airport in Dakhla in order to attract foreign tourists to visit the region.
Meanwhile, the city of Ouarzazate in south-central Morocco, known as the Door of the Desert, has been a center for filmmaking since the 1950s and recently featured in the blockbuster TV series Game of Thrones. Morocco's highly developed filming studios have positioned it competitively in the world film industry.
Morocco is an emerging country in the film industry in the international level. In 3 years, from 2011-2014, we tripled the amounts of the foreign investment in film industry by 11 times, from $10 million to more than $100 million.
Growth in Morocco, far from make-believe, now extends across all sectors. The country no longer depends on just a few key industries to support economic development. Morocco is set on a path of reform and development that will confirm the country's emergence as regional leader and gateway to Africa.
Aujourd'hui, nous continuons à travailler dans ce sens donc de diversification, nous continuons à libérer le maximum du potentiel de croissance dans notre pays, nous continuons à valoriser la situation stratégique de notre pays et nous continuons à travailler bien sûr dans l'environnement, l'amélioration de l'environnement des affaires pour améliorer le business, le travail donc dans notre pays d'une manière générale.
Investors recognize Morocco's unique location and the security it offers in a region that is all too often fraught by political instability.
The position, the stability, and the framework of the wind business in Morocco. All these elements explain why Morocco now is the most attractive place for foreign investments.
Morocco's model of growth is a model to be followed by others in the region.
Nous pensons que beaucoup de pays arabo-musulmans aujourd'hui sont en train de remarquer ce qui se passe au Maroc et sont en train de se dire, et si on faisait à peu près la même chose?
Ever more competitive at the global level, Morocco is poised to complete its evolution to a truly modern economy.
Nous voyons avec espoir l'avenir. Nous demandons à Dieu de nous aider, mais je crois que nous sommes en train aujourd'hui de nous ouvrir sur un avenir dans lequel le Maroc sera parmi les pays développés et sera parmi les pays à travers lesquels on peut aussi aider les autres pays voisins à se développer.